James Dyson, the vacuum maker, has been criticizing Rishi Sunak again. You may recall that James Dyson is the person who criticized Sunak for penalizing the private sector. He said it's a you can't be mad enough to think this is a free win in the ballot box. And Dyson was very much in love with Liz Truss and Kwasi Kwateng. He says, I was hopeful with Liz Truss and Kwasi Kwateng. I think he must have been the only person on the planet who was hopeful with Liz Truss. Liz Truss, let's not forget, was that person who brought to mind the extraordinary hand gestures, the hand jobs of Joe 90 and Captain Scarlet and the Thunderbirds are go! Thunderbirds are go! An extraordinary lip movement. Hand jobs and mouth movements of the puppets. Supercar. Stingray. Do you remember Stingray? It's Stingray still hurting today. And that sort of sums up Liz Truss. As for Kwasi Kwateng, I remember vividly that month where Liz Truss cast furtive looks at Kwasi Kwateng's prodigious package and urged us all to genuflect in its shadow. And it was nonsense. Anyway, Dyson was taken in. I thought they were doing the right thing. I'm the only one who did, yes. Kwateng wasn't raising taxes. He was going for growth, the prodigious package, which I think is the right thing. It allows us to pay for things and generates wealth. And Kwateng got sacked, and Truss lost her job, and she's put out postcards or Christmas cards in the last day or so, slightly sepia-tinted with nostalgia, and it makes her look faintly regal, as if she's sitting in number 10 Downing Street, lording it over us all. No, the person lording it over us all is Baroness Moon. Liz Truss is just some sort of has been on the back of an envelope. James Dyson says, wealth generation and growth became dirty words. I've always believed that inflation isn't quite the enemy everyone thinks it is. If you've got growth, a bit of inflation doesn't matter. If you get inflation down and kill growth, you're in trouble. And so he's concerned about Rishi Sunak's lack of growth creation. And he's lashed out at Sunak and Jeremy Hunt, accusing the government of not going for growth. And he's heaped praise on Liz Truss and Kwasi Kwateng. And he made his fortune, if you remember, he made his fortune in vacuum cleaning. And he was... say goodbye to the bag! Say goodbye to the bag, and that's not a reference to Liz Truss. Say goodbye to the bag was his slogan. And he was also, if you remember, very keen on the EU in the 1980s, and then suddenly had this conversion to Brexit in 2016. And having energised us all to love the UK, he's moved to Singapore after all the publicity to focus on the liberation of the UK from EU restraints. And that's not good enough for him either. This is a man who is not interested in consistency. I must say, on that, I agree with him. But, there are times when you have to realise that a vacuum cleaner is not just for Christmas. A vacuum cleaner is an investment for life, and it should be doing the same job. When you put it down on the floor, it should just suck. It shouldn't be blowing out all this hot air. And frankly, I think Dyson has confused one of his inventions with another. And there's a lot of hot air coming out of his direction, and it's not all coming out vocally. And though I entirely laud his criticism of Rishi Sunak, I think, well, what's the point of what's the point of him going on when he's already given up? He's given up. He's taken his trade elsewhere, having persuaded us all to invest in Britain. He's now gone off to Singapore. I don't see that as being particularly loyal or leading from the front. Mr. Dyson is a fake. So that's why. That's clearly why he likes Liz Truss. One puppet after another. One character with bizarre movement after another. I mean, maybe they could team together and produce some sort of super-marionated vacuum cleaners, which have a life of their own, all conducted by strings, and Dyson could pull the lot. Pull one over on us. I mean, it's all this flick of the wrist, sleight of hand stuff. I don't believe it. I think Dyson, like so many other people at the moment, just wants his voice to be heard. He just wants to remain relevant. And it doesn't really matter what he says. He'll change his mind tomorrow.